So good morning students. So in this class we'll be studying about fertilization and implantation. These are very important processes which we have to understand. Okay. So as you all know, the fertilization means fusion of male and female gametes. Okay. As we said, as the definition says, the fertilization is fusion of male as well as female gametes. But it is not as simple as that. Okay, so there are several steps which need to be taken care of. Okay, say for example, just write fertilization means fusion of male and female gametes to produce diploid zygote is known as fertilization. Okay, so as you know, both gametes, male gamete as well as female gamete, they both are haploid. They fuse together to form a diploid zygote. Okay, this is fertilization. But the explanation for this fertilization and implantation, they are very complicated processes, but we will explain in two different classes. Okay, for example, if you are preparing for the NEET exam, okay, say for example, if you are preparing for the NEET exam, then the explanation is very wide. Okay, so but in the regular theory classes, it is very simplified version. Okay, so here in the regular theory class or in the NCERT book which you will generally prefer, it contains very less explanation. It only tells us about the how the process goes on or what are the highlighted events which will take place during fertilization. But if you are preparing for the NEET class, the explanation is little wider. Okay, how the sperm enters, what are the enzymes which are released, and what is the role of the ovum, how the ovum takes this sperm, and what are the events when the sperm comes in attachment with the membrane of the ovum. So what all things happen, those all things will be studying for the NEET class, not in the regular theory class. Okay, so today we'll be only understanding the process theoretically. So today we'll be understanding this process theoretically. We are not concentrating on the NEET subject right now in this class. Okay, so I will just explain in the perspective of theory. Okay, because all students will be there, so for that reason I will be trying to explain this theoretically. Okay, as you all know, fertilization means the fusion of male and female gametes to produce a diploid zygote. Okay, so the fusion means generally when coitus or sexual intercourse, generally, or we simply write during coitus, it has several meanings. Okay, coitus, sexual intercourse, and what is one more thing? Copulation. There are several meanings of copulation. You can call it as copulation, coitus, or sexual intercourse. All these give the same meaning. So generally during coitus, generally male releases or male ejaculates. Simply write ejaculates. Male ejaculates around 3 to 3.5 ml of semen. Okay. Generally the ejaculation contains 3 to 3.5 ml of semen. So the sperm concentration, the sperm number of sperms, or I'll simply write the number of sperms here, sperm count will be generally around 200 to 300 million cells, million sperms. Okay, so this is the average, this is the normal sperm count. It should be there so to perform the event of fertilization. Okay, if the fertilization to take place, then the number should be around 300 to 300 million cells. Why? Because I will tell you further in the further process why the, that huge amount of number is required for the process of fertilization. Okay. So then the next point is during as we said, fertilization means fusion of male and female gametes. So this fusion of male and female gametes generally takes place in this region. Okay. This or this region. Okay, you can take. So this region. Generally, this region is called as ampullary. This is ampulla, right? This is ampulla, and this is isthmus. Okay, that is isthmus. This portion is isthmus. Okay, the junction where isthmus and ampulla they come in contact with each other. That junction is known as ampullary. Isthmus junction, I'll write here ampullary isthmic junction. So at this junction generally fertilization takes place. Fertilization means male and female gametes they fuse together in this particular region. Okay, that region is known as ampullary isthmic region. Okay, so if the fertilization takes place, say for example, I will try to tell you the process of fertilization here. Generally what happens, the egg will be released in the ovum. Okay, so after ovulation, during ovulation what happens, the ovary will release the ovum, that will be captured by the portion. What is that portion? That portion is known as fimbriae, okay, or infundibulum. So this will capture the ovum, and through this that ovum or ootate will travel all the way through the ampulla to the isthmus. So this will call it as fallopian tube also. Okay, so there it will, the egg will be the ovum will be retained in the fallopian tube for around 2 to 3 days. Generally 2 to 3 days it will be present in the fallopian tube. Got it? So the fertilization to take place, sperm, the male has to ejaculate the sperm through the vagina. The sperm will travel through the vaginary duct through cervix. From the cervix it has to travel all the way to the ampullary isthmic junction. Okay, so these two processes, okay, they have to take place simultaneously. Okay, so simultaneous means here egg release agutla, so adu ille 2 to 3 days irbeki ella fallopian tube olu irutthu. Okay, so adhe time olaga sperm adhe 2 to 3 days in period irutla, adhe period olaga ille banda ille through it has to eject from the vaginary duct in the cervix in the uterus, it has to come to the ampullary isthmic junction. Okay, so then only the fertilization will take place, otherwise it is difficult, or it is generally the fertilization will not take place. Okay, so these two processes has to take place simultaneously. Okay, so this is the reason why most of the copulations or most of the coitus, they generally don't proceed for the process of fertilization. Okay, in agathu generally maklan agabodu. So that is because the duration or the now simultaneously sperm ejaculation as well as egg fallopian tube athwa eradu junction ide enatla ampullary isthmic junction ಗೆ ಎರಡು ಸೈಮಲ್ಟೇನಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಬರು, ಈ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಎಗ್ ಬರಬೇಕು, ಈ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಬರಬೇಕು. ಅವಾಗಷ್ಟ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆಂಪ್ಯುಲರಿ ಇಸ್ಮಿಕ್ ಜಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಒಳಗಿದ್ದಾಗಷ್ಟ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಈ ಡ್ಯೂರೇಷನ್ ಒಳಗೆ ನೀವು ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಇಂಟರ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಅವಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಎಗ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾಗ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಬಂತು, ಅಥವಾ ಎಗ್ನ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಬಂದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋ ಕುಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಅವಾಗೆಲ್ಲ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ಜಲ್ದಿ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ದೇ ಬೋತ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ to the ampullary isthmic junction at the same time. Got it? So then, So this is about the fertilization. So next, the fertilization. Say for example, now both ovum as well as sperm, they both are simultaneously come together and they are fusing or fertilization is taking place. Okay, so if that fertilization is taking place, how again I have to think about that, we will try to understand. Okay, so now generally fertilization means fusion of gametes, means in the region of ampullary, I will write some points, in the region of ampullary isthmic junction, the male gamete that is sperm and female gamete that is ovum or ooted, they fuse together, they come in contact with each other, okay, each other. So during this point, sperm and egg, ovum, they come in contact with each other. During that phase, some events will take place. Okay, so we will try to concentrate on those events. So generally, what happens when sperm reaches the layer of zona pellucida? Okay, so if you see the structure of ovum here, so this is the structure of ovum. Okay, so if you just concentrate on the layers, first layer is the outer layer is zona pellucida, this layer. So this layer is zona pellucida. So black color is drawn on the layer of zona pellucida. The inside layer is a membrane. Okay, outer membrane of the egg or ovum. Ovum is the, this layer is plasma membrane. In red color, we are drawn on the layer. So that is plasma membrane. Right here. This layer is plasma membrane, which the red color is to plasma membrane. Okay, so now we try to understand when sperm reaches, say for example this particular sperm, so this particular sperm is already reached the region of zona pellucida, again black layer is attached. Okay, so when it reaches the zona pellucida layer, it induces some changes in the membrane of the ovum. Okay, so what happens? I will write the points here. So just remove this. All right, when sperm comes in contact with the zona pellucida layer. So what happens? It induces some changes in the membrane. It induces some changes in the membrane. Okay, so again I am saying generally cortical granulation they talk. Okay, the granules are known as cortical granules. Every change are taken there. Given evolved sperm and those zona pellucida layer is touched. The egg membrane in egg irukla, it releases some cortical granules. Okay, which deposit in the region of the empty space. I will try to draw in the empty space. It is called red and black color. So this layer is known as pre-vitelline space. So this is known as peri-vitelline space. Peri-vitelline space. So this peri-vitelline space, how formation happens? When the sperm comes in contact with the zona pellucida layer. Okay, so that induces the egg to release the cortical granules into the space. E granule. ovarium bag attached avaga it will induce the formation of cortical granules into the empty space. So that space is known as perivitrine space anta karithivi. Okay, so avaga enagutta only one sperm that perivitrine space edhu formation aagutara when first sperm comes in contact with one egg. Okay, this egg. So avaga enagutta only this sperm can penetrate into the ovum. So that means ಯಾವಾಗಿದು ಜೋನಾಪೆಲುಸಲ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಜೋನಾಪೆಲುಸಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಅಂತ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ಆ ಮೊಮೆಂಟ್ ಒಳಗ ಕಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಗ್ರಾನ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತವೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಾಟ್ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಲೇಯರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಗೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ನಾ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಇಲ್ಗೊಳಗಡೆ ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಓವಮ್ ವೇರ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೇಯರ್ ದ ಪೆರಿವಿಟ್ರೈನ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಲೌ ದ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಆಫ್ ಅದರ್ ಸೊ ಒಂದ್ ಯಾವ್ದೇ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಬಂದ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅದಷ್ಟೇ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ರಿಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಗ್ರಾನ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಅದು ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಗ್ರಾನ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲೀಡ್ ಟು ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೆರಿವಿಟ್ರೈನ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಲೌ ದ ಅದರ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಓವರ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಓವರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಓವರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡೆರಡು ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಅಂತ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಓವರ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಜನರಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಯು ಮೇ ಗೆಟ್ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಏನಪ್ಪ ಇದು ಒಂದೇ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಹೋಗಿ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಈ ಜವಳಿ ಜವಳಿಗಳು ಆಗ್ತಾವ ಸೊ ಅವ್ರು ಹೆಂಗಾಗ್ತವೆ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ಟ್ವಿನ್ಸ್ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಥ್ರೈಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಾವ ಟ್ವಿನ್ಸ್ ಮೂರು ತ್ರಿವಳಿಗಳು ಆಗ್ತವೆ ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನು ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪರ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ತ್ರಿವಳಿಗಳು ಅವಳು ಹೆಂಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾವಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇದ್ರೊಳಗೆ ನೋಡೋದು. ಸೊ ಬಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ನಾವು ಓನ್ಲಿ one sperm will enter into the ovum ಒಂದು ಒಂದೇ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಹೋಗುದು ಬೇರೆ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಹೋಗಕ್ ಚಾನ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಇದ್ರಿ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಅಟಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಜನೋಪಲಿಸಿಡಲಿಯಾ ಇಟ್ ಇಂಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್. ಸೊ ಏನ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿನ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲೀಡ್ ಟು ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೆರಿವಿಟ್ರೈನ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅಟಮ್ಸ್ the head portion of the sperm contains acrosome. Okay, so gonopetalidae to the head portion of the acrosome of the sperm releases some enzymes which degrade this gonopetalidae and it will reach acrosome. Sperm release the some enzymes which degrade a small space in Jonah pellucida and reaches plasma membrane of the ovum. Okay, so here very clearly when acrosome head it contains several enzymes, so those will act on the Jonah pellucida layer or degrade agutha Jonah pellucida layer and degrade madutha and it will reach the plasma membrane of the ovum. Okay, so when it reaches to the plasma membrane of the ovum then also some activities will take place. Okay, so we try to write here when sperm reaches the plasma membrane, plasma membrane of the ovum, it induces the ovum to undergo, it induces or particular right, when sperm reaches the plasma membrane of the ovum, it induces meiosis 2 in the ovum. Okay, so which means we have to look back into the ovum or oogenesis process in the ovum to note better. Okay, where you might have, you just remember or you recall, if you can recall what happens, primary follicle in the oogenesis process hota hai, oogenesis ko kya hai, primary follicle or primary oocyte rehte, so primary follicle will divide into secondary follicle, secondary to tertiary follicle agar hum bata karte, inside which primary oocyte will be there, if you can recall primary follicle, secondary follicle and tertiary follicle. So in the tertiary follicle the oocyte, primary oocyte will be there. Avaga yen irutte, we only first oocyte will start undergoing meiosis first. Okay, meiosis first oraga prophase phase oraga diploid stage oraga stop agutte thirinalana, stop agirutte allu divide agutte. So what happens in the meiosis first will take place, which lead to the formation of secondary oocyte. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಟರ್ಷರಿ ಫಾಲಿಕಲ್ ಒಳಗ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಯೂಸೈಟ್ ಇರ್ತೈತಿ, ಸೊ ಯಾವಾಗದು ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಆ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಒಳಗ ಮಿಯೋಸಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್, ಇರೋ ಆ ಮಿಯೋಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲೀಡ್ ಟು ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೂ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಟ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲೀಡ್ ಟು ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ರಿ ಊಸೈಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪೋಲಾರ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯಾವಾಗ ಊಜೆನಿಸ್, ಸೊ ಆ ಊಜೆನಿಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಮಿಯೋಸಿಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ನೀವು ಪೂಜೆನೆಸ್ ಒಂದ್ಸರಿ ಓದ್ರಿ, ತಿಳಿಯಿಲ್ಲ ಒಂದ್ಸರಿ ಊಜೆನೆಸ್ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಡಿ, ಸ್ಯಾಮಿಟೈನಿಸ್ಲಿ ಈ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸ್ ನೋಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕಲ್ಲ, ಸೈಡ್ ಆ ಊಜೆನೆಸಸ್ದು ನೋಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ಕೊಡಿ. ಸೊ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವಾಗ ನಾ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ, ವೆನ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ರೀಚಸ್, ವೆನ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ರೀಚಸ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮಾ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಆ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮಾ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್ ರೀಚ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು, ಎಕ್ರೋಸೋಮ್ ಇರ್ತೈತಿ, ಎಕ್ರೋಸೋಮ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಸಮ್ ಎಂಜೈಮ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ, ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಗ್ರೇಡ್ ದ ಜೋನಾ ಪೆಲ್ಯೂಸಿಡಾ ಲೇಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ರೀಚ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮಾ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್. So during, when it reaches the plasma membrane of the ovum, it induces the ovum to undergo the second meiotic division. So second meiosis agaga idal padu. Okay, so idu second meiosis agidandre adartha first meiosis already agibekla avudilli. So ee first meiosis elli agirutti, elli naavu secondary oocyte release agutala, elli tertiary follicle olaga secondary oocyte release agutti by releasing one polar body, first polar body. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪೋಲರ್ ನೋಡಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಿಯಾಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ, ಮಿಯಾಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಏನು ಎರಡು ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಹಾಕೋಲ್ಲ, ದಕ್ಷಿಣ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಹಾಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಅದೇ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅರೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್, ಸೊ ದ ಪೋಲಾರ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಇಟ್ ಡಿಜನರೇಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಆ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ರಿ ಊಸೈಟ್ ಏನಿರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ, ದಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಿಯೋಸಿಸ್. ಮಿಯೋಸಿಸ್ ಟು ವೆನ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತದೆ, ವೆನ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ರೀಚಸ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮಾ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಮಿಯೋಸಿಸ್, ವಿಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲೀಡ್ ಟು ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೂ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತೀನಿ, ಐ ರೈಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ವೆನ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ರೀಚಸ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮಾ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಓವಮ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಂಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಮಿಯೋಸಿಸ್ ಟು ಇನ್ ದ ಓವಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಿಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲೀಡ್ ಟು ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್, it will lead to the formation of, it will lead to the formation of secondary polar body. So enagutri meiosis ni correct aagi nenpa padkodre andre first meiosis olla erdu sala irutto, second meiosis complete aadaga naaku sala irutto. Okay, so but ಈ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಅಥವಾ ಓಮ್ ಹೂ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಓವರಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಮಿಯೋಸಿಸ್ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಸೆಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಸೆಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದು ಒಂದು ಸೆಕೆಂಡರಿ ಓಸೈಟ್ ಆಗ್ತೈತಿ, इन फर्स्ट पोलार बॉडी आ फर्स्ट पोलार बॉडी फर्स्ट पोलार बॉडी डीजनरेट आगे होते ओनली सर ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೋ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಮಿಯಾಮ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಆಗಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಎರಡರಿಂದ ಬದಲಿ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಒಂದೇ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಓಕೆ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಇಂಟು ಟು ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೋ ದೋಸ್ ಟು ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಲೀಡ್ ಟು ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪೋಲಾರ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಊಟಿಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪೋಲಾರ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡರಿ ಓಸೈಟ್ ಆರ್ haploid oomphalocele it will lead to the formation of second polar body and a haploid oom okay so at this point haploid oom may occur occasionally when sperm reaches the plasma membrane of the oom so it will induce the meiosis second to take place so after the second meiosis two kinds of cells will be produced first second polar body and the haploid oom so this haploid is also oom is also called as ootid okay so this haploid oom is called as ootid or simply egg anthocyte okay this is the female gamete functional female gamete functional female gamete so this gamete will fuse with the sperm got it so now here so it is also unequal division second meiosis meiosis 2 is also 2 is also unequal division unequal division okay so where the ootid or haploid oom will retain maximum cytoplasm and the polar body only nuclei very less cytoplasm it will be released out and it will be degenerated second polar body is also degenerated only the it will lead to the oom this will become the female gamete as ootid so now what happens now I will write just remove this now the haploid sperm and haploid ootid fuse together to form a zygote a diploid zygote okay so this process is known as fertilization got it so yenagutte fertilization quick recall so this fertilization generally will take place at the junction of ampullary isthmic region right so these two the ovulation as well as the oom as well as the sperm they has to simultaneously reach to the region of isthmus or ampullary isthmic region eradu at a time barbeku then there what happens sperm first reaches the outside layer of the zona pellucida so zona pellucida reach aagapudu enna agutta it induces some changes in the membrane of the oom okay so ye changes agutre it will lead to the formation of perivitreline space okay so that perivitreline space prevents the entry of other sperms right so bere sperm bara barulaga ee perivitreline space prevent madutte so then what happens it the acrosome head of the sperm releases some enzymes that will degrade the zona pellucida and reaches the membrane appa ovary the oom the membrane illa oom membrane reach agutte so when the sperm reaches the oom membrane appa egg membrane reach agutte anakati second meiosis will take place right so second meiosis will lead to the formation of second polar body as well as a haploid oom it is called as ootid also okay so when it completes the meiosis, meiosis ever complete agutala avaga haploid ovum formation agutte. So this haploid ovum or oocyte fuses with the haploid sperm forming a zygote, diploid zygote. So this here it completes the process of fertilization. Got it? So now what happens after fertilization? That we have to look into. Okay? So now we will begin. Zygote formation karita. So now we will try to understand what happens after formation of zygote. Okay? So as the zygote. Okay? So zygote form. But exactly at this stage, zygote in formation akatla, at this stage only we can determine the whether the baby will be male or female. Okay, zygote formation. So this is the exact point where we can decide whether the baby which is developing, zygote in develop akatla, the baby will develop. So that baby will be male or female. Annodanna ee zygote stage lo helabodu. Okay, so that means why? And then one more problem. Say for example, is sperm throw. Okay, this is the sperm, right? So sperm throw haploid number of chromosomes. Haploid are actually we have 23 pair. Okay, that is diploid. Haploid are linear, it will be having 23 chromosomes. Sperm will be having 23 chromosomes, right? So adhe tara haploid egg or oocyte will be having 23 chromosomes. So this is female egg, oocyte, and this is male sperm. Okay, so both will be having 23 chromosomes. 23 chromosomes. Okay, so you ee chromosomes nodidrandre out of 23 chromosomes, out of 23, 22 chromosomes are autosomes. 23 ಒಳಗೆ 22 ಕ್ರೋಮೋಸೋಮ್ ಆಟೋಸೋಮ್ ಸಿಗ್ತವೆ ಅಂಡ್ 1 ಕ್ರೋಮೋಸೋಮ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಆಟೋಸೋಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೋ ಆಟೋಸೋಮ್ಸ್ ಇವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾವ, ದೇ ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಟೋಸೋಮ್ ದೇ ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಸೆಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೋ ಈ ಕ್ರೋಮೋಸೋಮ್ ಸಿಗ್ತವೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೀಕಾಲ್ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, haploid number of chromosomes ento n number of chromosomes, so that is n number 23 chromosomes ento. Out of 23 chromosomes, 22 will define the body character and the one chromosome is called as allosome, that will define the sex of the organism. Got it? So this takes place, ee sex determination na generally yavaga ketan zygote formation agutte. Okay, so now we'll quick look into how it takes place. Generally, if you can recall, male will be having X chromosome, sorry, XY chromosome. Male will be having XY chromosome, and female will be having XX chromosome. Is it? During gamete formation, the male can release either X chromosome or Y chromosome. Okay, this is another possibility. Male candidate, he can give X chromosome as well as Y chromosome. XY chromosome or YY chromosome. Yeah, one product. Okay, another at a time product. One. Okay, so that means here the sperm which is produced, it may contain X chromosome or it may contain Y chromosome. Tita? Whereas female has the capacity to only give X chromosome. So gametes will be only X. Okay, so this is oocyte. Okay, so now male agutandra this, so say for example, I'll write it here. If male baby agutandra, Y from the male has to come and X from the female, because no, female will only give one X chromosome. So these have to fuse together, leading to XY. So this will become male baby. Okay. So if male if this chromosome, this set of chromosome, this sperm will come and fuse together with the, this female gamete, then it will lead to the formation of female baby. X, male in the X one, female in the X one. Now this baby will become female. Got it? So sperm will be containing either X chromosome or Y chromosome. Okay, so here the male parent will be the deciding factor. Okay, which means the male person is responsible for the birth of female baby or male baby. If the sperm, male sperm, hello, X is the sperm, female gamete fuse or female agarte. If Y is the sperm, one egg gamete fuse or male baby. Okay, so parent yaar decide maartarli generally illa only ee kelavu manaya antirtar ee athiyo social card irtar ee bari hannade athini gannade avali gannade anthe. Okay, so adu avu beyvaka helbaga athi hogi yen anthe hele bayudo ee social bay madre ee magan bayre anthe helu chita. That means that deciding factor whether the baby is going to be male or female, that deciding factor is present in the male person, male parent, because male only gives you X, Y, two kinds of gametes, right? So this is the process of sex determination. Okay. Now next process is implantation. What after zygote formation? Now zygote after is another thing. Okay. So now after zygote, soon after zygote formation, nearly get the in this region. Ampullary isthmic region. Okay, it has to travel all the way through the fallopian tube. Okay, divide the movement of the ovum. Okay, I will try to tell that. Soon after the zygote formation, mitotic division in zygote starts. Mitotic division starts and the zygote will interpenetrate. Soon after the zygote formation, the mitotic division, zygote enagutta mitotically divide agta hogutta, simultaneously it will start moving towards the uterus. Okay, so soon after the mitotic division in the zygote starts and the zygote start moving towards uterus. Okay, so this process is known as cleavage. This process is known as cleavage. Okay, so generally cleavage say for example zygote irutte, zygote will divide into male and female body irutte, one zygote ikkada agutte, idu hinga control agutte cell. Okay, so this will again matter further divide agutte 2 4 6 8 7 and that will try to tell you. Mitotic division in the zygote starts and the zygotes are moving towards the uterus, that is known as cleavage. Okay, this cleavage again cell divide agutte cleavage. So right now just put sir. Mitotic division in the zygote starts and zygote starts going towards the uterus, which is called as cleavage. Then this cleavage is followed by the number of cells. Cell cleavage after the zygote will divide into 2, 4, 8, and 16 cell. Blastomeres. Okay, so zygote in USA for example, it laid one credit chromosome. I will remove this. Okay, say for example, this is the egg and it has already released the male gamete into zygote egg. Okay, zygote will divide. One is to do ओके सो ಎರಡು अगेन 4 ಆಗುತ್ತೆ मास ऑफ सेल्स This is 1, this is 3 meter, 11 by 2, 4, 8 cell, 8 angle, again 16 cells in the So now, you can get you know, each cell, when you divide after, you have blastomere and delta. You tell a blastomere and delta. Blastomere. Okay, when this blastomere reaches, the 16 cell stages okay now that is called as or blastomeres enagutte ek barcode the zygote will divide into 2 cell 4 cell 8 cell 16 cell cell blastomeres then at the stage of 8 to 16 blastomere stage 8 to 16 blastomere stage is called as morula stage called as morula okay so our 8 11 18 or 16 okay yavaga 16 8 alva 4 is 8 agutha direct 16 bundal 4 is 8 agutha 8 and it will lead to the dividing and 16 cell there yavaga 16 cell stage reach agutha 8 to 16 adakke enta ketinaa morula agutha Okay, so again the morula will be dividing for identification 8 to 16 cells is that is called hesser motif. Entire morula. Okay, so that morula that will be traveling. Okay, fallopian tube move aata hoga kar Okay, so that the 16 cells is that it will reach the uterus morula. Okay, so then what happens? The morula continues to divide. Morula continues to divide into 32 14 into 32 64 blastomere stage okay so this 32 64 stage cell stage adaniki enti antaram blastocyst antaru stage called blastocyst right so ye lagta morula indudu 16 agutte so adarinda 32 32 athva 64 stage cell ay divide agutte so eradu stage olaga en telthirutta blastocyst anta helthi blastocyst got it so ivagalu 32 to 64 stage agutta blastocyst anta helthi So this blastocyst yavaga develop agutti when idu when the developing main mass of cells in divide aagala aa divide aagakka hodanga uterus olaga hogutho so uterus olaga it will form a layer around it that layer I will try to tell you okay so this blastocyst forms the outer covering known as trophoblast idu sutta enagutte one layer say for example this is blastocyst ankorge ile ta ee cell na blastocyst ankoru unfold aage iruthe ee outer layer ena it forms a covering okay so idike enta kettu trophoblast anta kettu trophoblast idha so adike outer covering na blastocyst forms a outer covering forms a outer covering called as trophoblast anta helthi trophoblast okay and the inner cell mass ge anta helthi inner olagare en cells divide they differentiate into embryo idike anta helthi now inner cell mass inner cell mass. So blastocyst forms outer covering known as tropoblast and the inner cells which were dividing. So those are known as inner cell mass. Okay. So now what happens? This tropoblast, again tropoblast form it fuses with the endometrium or we will try to tell you. The tropoblast gets attached to the endometrium. ಈ ಯುಟ್ರೈನ್ ವಾಲ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನರ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಲ್ ಯಾವ್ದಂತ ಎಂಡೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಯಂ. ಸೊ ಆ ಯುಟ್ರೈನ್ ವಾಲ್ಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ಎಂಡೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಯಂ ಹೋಗಿ ಇದು ಟ್ರೋಪೋಬ್ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಆಸ್ ಸೂನ್ ಆಸ್ ಟ್ರೋಪೋಬ್ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಮೂವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಟೈಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಮಿ ಡ್ರಾ ದ ಯುಟ್ರೈನ್ ವಾಲ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ so this is the uterine cavity. Okay, inner more wall cervix. Okay, ilya sir, ye diagram sum draw kar draw karta hai na. So this is the endometrium. Endometrium ko kya ilya lagta mass of cells kya ho lo blastocyst will come and attach. Okay, idu blastocyst. So outer layer entry blastocyst with the tropoblast. Tropoblast one the uterine wall ge antagonize gets itself attached to the uterine wall or endometrium. Endometrium ge one the attached. So after attachment what happens? The endometrium whatever is the endometrium is in the contact wall is that divides rapidly. So ee uterine endometrium is the sutta belidu. So we draw, try to draw with different color the endometrium. This is endometrium this layer. So it surrounds it rapidly. Endometrium wall divides rapidly to surround itself around the blastocyst. So surrounding okay. So this is surrounding endometrium wall. ಸರ್ವ್ ಸೊ ನಾವ್ ದ ಬೇಬಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಎಂಡೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಯಂ ವಾಲ್. ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್? ನಾವ್ ವಿಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ದ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ದ ಟ್ರೋಪೋಬ್ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ಡ್ ಟು ದ ಎಂಡೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಯಂ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಇನ್ನರ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇನ್ನರ್ ಸೆಲ್ mass differentiate into embryo. Okay, inner cell mass embryo, the outer wall tropoblast will attach to the endometrium. Okay, so now the endometrium after attachment, the cells of endometrium, the cells of uterus or endometrium divide rapidly and covers the blastocyst okay. So E process can be known implantation. This process is known as implantation. Got it? So here number three, the blastocyst will form outer covering known as protoblast. The inner cell mass is, inner cells are known as inner cell mass. So that inner cell mass will develop into embryo, and the outer protoblast is the it gets itself attached to the endometrium wall. So the endometrium wall, they differentiate or they divide rapidly to form a covering around the blastocyst. Okay, so this process can take now implantation. Got it? So this is known as implantation. So next, the implant, after implantation, it will lead to the pregnancy. After implantation, it will lead to pregnancy. Okay, this implantation is very important. Okay, generally what happens, sometimes the developing blastocyst can develop after that. Okay, the fallopian tube is there. So this is the fallopian tube. See, fallopian tube is there, divide after work, birth is there. Morula is the blastocyst. In Kelantan, it will not be attached to the endometrium wall. Okay, it will go out of the vagina. Okay, so again, the doctors are going to tell Garb and Indra also. So that's the developing embryo will not be retained by the wall of the endometrium. That is, there are several conditions. Okay, so here we have the morula, these cells for fertilization, zygote formation, it will lead to the formation of morula, blastocyst cells. But implantation is not there. Okay, implantation is not blastocyst endometrium wall attached. Okay, so attached to the endometrium cells in the endometrium cover part of the blastocyst. Sometimes this will not happen. Okay, during that process time, this the embryo which is developing, it will degrade and get outside vagina through outside hole. So they can get from garbh nilangal ketu. Okay, so that will not lead to the pregnancy. Only implantation is very important for the pregnancy to occur. Got it? So yavaga after implantation attachment aadrode the uterine cells, they have to form a cells surrounding itself. The cells divide out or layer formation maadu. So avaga enagutte, it will be attached and alle idu kooduthi alle embryonic development start. Okay, adakke entirthu pregnancy antirthu. So this is the process of fertilization and implantation. In the next class we will try to look into the next aspect, that is pregnancy and embryonic development. Okay, thank you.